Hey, greetings, folks. Larry Barone is here in Fort Worth, Texas. And I, first of all, like to thank everybody for all the comments I received on the passing of our beloved Cubby, who passed away December 28th. That was on a Wednesday.
Monday.
I'm sorry, on a Monday at 5:15 p.m. So, thank you for all the kind words and prayers that have been sent. I'm still not up to par, so please bear with me. I'm struggling every day with this because, you know, Cubby was my heart, Cubby's family, and I've taken it pretty hard. So please bear with me. All right, now I'm going to do a little something here in reverse. I've given you my top three pins for 2020. And, you know, I stand by that. That's for me only. What I'm fixing to do now is I'm going to do my top 10 today. And then either tomorrow or the next day, I'm going to do my top 5. And then later, I'm going to give you my top journal for 2020 and pin case for 2020. So you want to stay close to your set when these come on. So, first of all, and I do have some honorable mentions as well. Let's get ready here. And I'll get everything ready. Okay, and this is no particular order, okay? So, we're going to go right down here. We're going to start off right here with the Birmingham Beetlejuice. You know, really a nice, beautiful fountain pen. I love the colors. I like the way it feels. A very nice, well-made fountain pen, in my opinion. And a very nice nib on it. It's got the Nimbuson number 6 nib, the medium nib, and it's really sweet. Smooth, wet, a consistent writer. So I had to put that in the top 10. Too bad it didn't have a clip, because, you know, I'm a clip guy. But I use this quite a bit, so I have to use it in a pen case. Too bad I couldn't carry it in my pocket. So that's number one. And, Mr. Announcer, this is
The Euchers.
Yes, Euchers fountain pen. It's a beautiful fountain pen. And thank you to Loretta for sending me this pen. And what's unique about this, it has a felt tip. Okay, it uses a converter or a cartridge. Pretty cool. And what I like about these felt tips, you don't need to put a lot of pressure down when you're writing with them. They just glide across the paper. And you can use your favorite inks. And Euchers as well has their own lot of inks that I found to be very nice as well. So it's a big plus for Euchers in my book, and they are affordable. So, you know, if let's say that your tip is getting dull finally, because sometimes we tend to put a lot of pressure on these felt tips. Well, they're affordable, so that's a plus, okay?
And the tips come in different sizes as
well. Yes, they do, uh-huh. And there's different sizes. You have the, your youth one, and they go up to different ones. Just go to the website, which is just put in...
Look for Euchers, you should find it. Y-O-O-K-E-R-S. Yeah.
And while you're at it, tell Loretta or whoever there, you heard it from Larry's Fountain Pens. Cool. So, here we go. Another pen that really blew me away this year, you know, I'm a Noodler's guy. Love Noodler's pens. Love the Music Nib. I just love the Ahab. You name it. They have great pens. Affordable. And pens where you can tinker with them, get to know pens. But when this little baby came out, the Noodler's Triple Tail. Affordable. I had to check it out, so I bought this pen. And this pen was amazing. Totally. Yes, people call it a fire hose. I love it. Wet, smooth, consistent ink flow. For me, it just was right there. Everything I wanted in a fountain pen. I just really think this pen is a very cool fountain pen. Not a lot of bucks, but you get a lot of pen for the money. This is one of the newest from Fountain Pen Revolution here in Plano, Texas. It's called the Tenoshi Fountain Pen. Beautiful fountain pen. Kevin has gotten with a Japanese maker, and they put their heads together and they came up with this beautiful fountain pen. And as you see here, Fountain Pen Revolution is now engraving. So you might want to check their site for different types of engraving. A beautiful, stunning fountain pen with a really nice nib on it. Again, this nib is wet, smooth, and I found it to be a nice, consistent writer grading flow. I haven't had any problems with it. And it's affordable. I believe it's under maybe $100. You have to look at the site because I forget what they cost. And, of course, you have to have the Sailor 1911, right? Beautiful fountain pen. Stunning. Love the new color that they came out a few years ago with a 14K gold nib. And this has a medium fine. Just a really pleasant, wonderful writer. I just use it a lot. So all these pens I've been using a lot. And in my opinion, I believe it's affordable. Now here's an oldie but goodie, the Jim Hines. This is the Blue Storm. Now this is one of my favorites because I was able to name this fountain pen. So that was cool. You know, I really love this fountain pen. And, of course, the Beacon 2 I have, but I had to go with this one. I love the color, the feel. It's got a beautiful 14K number 6 Jowo gold nib on it. Comes with a converter. This pen had just been fantastic for all the years that I've had it, and it's a pen that I think if you buy it, you're going to be really satisfied with the pen. If you like a wet, smooth nib, if you like an excellent custom pen, check out Hines. See what you think. Don't forget, tell him Larry sent you. That's all you need to know. He needs to know. He'll guide it from there. So, all right. I'm a big Conklin fan, for sure. Love Conklin. Here is their latest Conklin Courage. I have the whole set. I had to have all three of them. So, I just picked this one to show you. Beautiful pen. Stunning. Love all the detail. The trim work. It just beautiful, and comes with this beautiful black nib, Jowo number 6 nib, and of course you can twist these nibs out and put a different one in. Affordable nibs. This is a broad nib, and it's smooth, wet. This pen for me delivers. I'm really excited about Conklin raising the bar. That means they heard the feedback from the people about the nibs, the problems they were having, and they got on it and they took care of it. And a big plus for Conklin fountain pens. You know, I love them. To be honest with you, I haven't had any problems with any of my Conklin. They've been great. So these, in my opinion, are well worth the money that you put into this pen. I think about $125 or so dollars, but well worth the money. All right. Here's a baby, my newest one. Pilot got to be number one for me. That was in my top three. Stunning. This is the newest limited edition Link Blank. If you could just feel the texture on this fountain pen, the beauty of this fountain pen, and what makes this fountain pen for me so unique, so convenient, so handy, is the click action. Click and go, bam, you know. You don't have to worry about unscrewing it, if you need to post it. It's all convenient. The only problem that I heard that some of the people dislike about this pen was where the clip is put. For me, never had a problem with this pen. The clip never got in my way. And again, it's just a really unique fountain pen that I carry daily. I may carry a different colored one, but hey, they're convenient. Like I said, I don't have to worry about unscrewing it, posting it, or putting the cap down, writing with it. I just click and go. Use a converter, or it uses the Pilot cartridges. Okay, so very cool fountain pen. This was a little bit higher end than your standard Vanishing Point, but not at your highest end, okay? Now here's a baby. The Mont Blanc. The Beatles. Sgt. Pepper fountain pen. Nice weight to it. I like heavy pens. I like the way it looks. I like the colors in the fountain pen. Of course, if you know the Sgt. Pepper's album, there you go. That speaks for itself. It really is a cool pen. And it does have Mont Blanc on the bottom of the pen. Beautiful, stunning fountain pen with the four mustaches, John, Paul, George, and Ringo. Very awesome. And got a nice 14K little nib, but they made it black to, I guess, match the color of the pen. It is piston filler right here. Very cool. Very awesome. Love it. And number 10. Let's talk serious fountain pens right here. The Visconti Crystal Dream. I think this pen will speak for itself. You know, the new design, the ink window where you can see the ink levels, and you can just kind of see it just slushing around your pen. Then get that magnetic cap off, and then you'll see another little window there. And what is Visconti has done, if we can get a close look up of that. As Visconti listened to their customers, they had a lot of complaints about the Palladium nibs, the Dream Touch nibs. They changed to in-house gold nibs now. So all their nibs are in-house. 18K gold nib. Beautiful nib. This pen is to die for. The nib is to die for. Smooth, wet, and Visconti, congratulations. You're right in there. Okay, so that's 10. My top 10 pens. And out of those top 10 pens, I brought you my top three. Okay, Mr. Announcer, I'll do the honors. This is honorable mentions to
Zenzoy.
Yes, beautiful fountain pen. I've got a couple here, and the other two are going to be cleaned. So these are really excellent fountain pens. These have fine nibs in it. And let me tell you, I'm totally impressed. Yes, they are metal pen with lacquer. Beautiful, very affordable, under $50. And they come with a converter. Very nice. Or you can use a standard cartridge on this. And the fine nib, I've done reviews on all these pens. Wet, smooth. This pen truly delivered and needed an honorable mention for this pen. Great pen. Last but not least on the honorable mention, I have about four or five of these pens. But when I saw the new limited edition from Pen Chalet, I'm sorry, from Gold Spot Pens, beg your pardon, Gold Spot Pens, Tom was showing this pen, and it's a Kaweco, beautiful blue, but what I liked about it, it had Gold Spot Pens on one side and Kaweco on the other, and to my understanding, Gold Spot Pens didn't ask Kaweco to do it. I think Kaweco just went ahead and did it. Some people don't like it. They didn't find that to look well on this pen. For me, I thought it was brilliant. I really dig this. Cool. Gold Spot Pens, I love it. Looks great. So, this pen, you can use Kaweco cartridges, which you know I have, but don't ask me where. Oh, there they are. Yep. I've got some cartridges because I wanted to try out Kaweco black ink, which I like. So, or you can use the Kaweco converter. And here you go. But what I like about this nib, one reason why I got this pen, another reason why I got this pen, double broad nib. I just had to get my hands on it and test it out, so I bought this pen. And let me tell you, Kaweco did this nib right on the money. Love the double broad nib, wet, smooth. This pen delivers. Thinking about getting one of the metal ones to carry in my pocket. I do have clips for these, but beautiful writer, well worth the money. If you're interested in a Kaweco, check them out. The great fountain pens. Whoever you buy any of these pens from, tell them you heard it from Larry's Fountain Pen. Well, my friends, that's going to do it today. And I guess before I leave, I want to mention a couple of new inks before I go. When you buy the Conklin Courage, they come with this bottle of Conklin Courage black ink. Excellent ink. I love the ink. Really a nice black. And Birmingham inks. Birmingham has got some really dynamite inks. Affordable inks. And these inks are really sweet. And what I'm hearing from Birmingham is that now they're making their hand pouring their own inks at their shop. So this is a slag gray, I believe. Nice, beautiful color. You can get them in different mills. Then here's the ice rink. You get them at 30 mil or you can get them in the 60 mil. Both affordable. So that's what I have for you today, my friends. So you want to stay, like I said, tuned for my top five. Things are kind of reversed right now. things were done late, not what I planned. All this was planned to be done New Year's Eve, New Year's Day, but since the loss of Cubby, that kind of threw everything off whack, and I'm still dealing with that. So forgive me if I'm not up to par. I'm doing my best to get back in the saddle again. So with that said, be safe out there. We got this new virus coming at us now. Of course, the vaccine out, but a lot of us hadn't got it yet. So you need to be safe. You need to be careful. You need to listen up. If you want to stay around, stay safe for yourself, your family, and your friends. Love your pets. Pick up your doggies or your cats or whatever and give them some love. Seriously, your pets are family too. Love your doggies. Because once they're gone, it's going to put a void in your heart you can't replace. A lot of peace, a lot of love, and a lot of dynamite hugs to each and every one of you. Hope you had a happy new year. Mine wasn't all that great after I lost my cubby. So take care, my friends, and please don't text and drive. Bye-bye.